Hi, I'm Nick Regine, the Professor of Crystal. Welcome to this episode of Ask the Professor. Today I'm fortunate to have Wyatt White from Beadalon. Wyatt is the product manager for Beadalon, and Wyatt, welcome. We know that you're going to show us some basic jewelry techniques.
Yes, thanks, Nick. It's great to be here.
So Wyatt, please show us what you have in front of you.
Well, when you're talking about basic stringing, you really are talking about the nuts and bolts of all jewelry. And you need to have the proper way to finish the ends. That's probably the biggest thing that people have a stop with. And it's really not that difficult. We try to make it very, very simple by putting a lot of the information right on the spools of wire.
Great.
This is a new bead called a Cabochette. It's a wonderful half-faceted, half-plain bead that is just a very interesting, and I think design-wise, it's going to be a very, very fun bead to use. Then we have some what they call mini beads in a round and in an oval, and these particular beads are crystal blue shade. Wonderful new color. And I've selected today to be using the Beadalon satin silver 49-strand wire. 49-strand because we want more flexibility. These beads are sort of small, so they're going to lay very nicely.
That's going to blend right in with that color. It's almost going to be like seamless where you want
I think it's going to be really, really lovely for it. And of course, I'm going to need a number two crimp bead because that's what I like to use. A number two crimp bead uses the standard crimp plier. So we're just going to pull some wire out. And I usually don't cut the strand at first when I'm stringing because you don't know how long you're going to make it. So I just start stringing.
I like that you put the plastic back on there to kind of hold the wire because a lot of times you do see people cut it and then they put tape down on one end. So it's actually going to stop the bead from falling.
If you just string right to the spool, it's just a nice way to that you don't have to worry about the beads coming off either.
It's a great tip.
So we're just going to keep putting some beads on. Just going to kind of be a big bead, little bead design at the moment. And you can see how this, how the wire is blending very well with these beads. It virtually becomes invisible in the satin colors with these particular crystal beads. Now, because we're using 49-strand 024, which is a larger size of the Beadalon wire, I'm going to take the number two crimp bead because I like crimp beads better than crimp tubes. Personal preference only. Put one of those out, and you're going to string that onto the end of your wire. And notice I'm working at the end of the wire. I haven't cut the wire yet.
Yeah.
So we just need to work to one end right now. Crimp bead goes on, goes through the clasp. Then you just run this back through the crimp bead. Now, when you pull this, the wire is going to want to cross. Here you can see that the wire has crossed itself. To uncross it, you just need to twist and then hold with your left hand here so that those wires stay parallel inside the crimp bead. That can be a problem when crimping as well because you don't want the wire on top of the wire and then crimp it. The wires need to be side by side. The crimp tool is the best way to finish this. You place the crimp bead on the end and you mash. That makes it oval. Then you bring the oval back here to the back part of the crimp plier, and that's going to sort of form it into a bean shape. That center portion is going to push it down. And you can notice here that there's a wire on one side and a wire on the other side. That's the important part of keeping those wires parallel inside there so you don't have wire cutting wire inside there.
That's a great tip for beaders.
Then you're going to turn 90 degrees and then place that back in the end of the crimp plier and you're going to squeeze and that should fold it over on itself. That's all the crimping that you need to do. That's the proper way to crimp and the most safe for damaging the wire the least when crimping. A lot of times the issues that will arrive from incorrectly crimping.
Okay, so Wyatt, you put on the crimp bead, showed us how to properly do that. Mm-hmm. What's the next step?
Well, the next step, I'm going to cut the wire. Here, I didn't put the wire back through the beads because I'm using these bead bumpers at the end. So I'm going to cut this very close to the crimp bead. So you're just going to pull these away a little bit. I'm going to use a flush cutter.
Okay.
And a flush cutter is a plier that has a flush surface. That should always be facing the part of the jewelry that's going to be left. So in order to get in flush or close, you need to just slide that in there and just very carefully snip that off. So now we have that done. Now, if you want to fancy this up a little bit, which I of course do, we're going to use a crimp cover. And I think because of the clasp, I think I'm just going to use a plain one on this one. So I just need to get one of these out. They're sort of like a little Pac-Man bead that's got its mouth open. And you just have to feed it with the crimped crimp bead.
Okay.
So I just feed the little crimp cover with the crimp bead. Now I take the mighty crimp plier to close it. So I'm just going to put it in the very end and carefully close first one side a little bit, then roll it over and close the other. You just want that to come together. And I just go sort of back and forth, trying not to mar the surface of the crimp cover. And just get that to close nice and tight, just like that. And you've got your crimp cover now over the crimp bead.
That looks a lot more decorative. That's really mm-hmm. great.
I now just push the bead bumpers up to the edge of the crimp cover and then slide the beads down. Now we're going to do the same process on the other side. And that cush portion right here is going to give you, it's going to give the wire the amount of movement necessary so that the wire doesn't try to unstrand to give itself the movement that it needs. Now we're to the other side, so we're going to cut the wire. I like to use about 2 inches for this end, just so you have enough to be able to move the wire around. So first we're going to string on our 3 bead bumpers and the third. Slide these down. And that can go just like that. And bend the bracelet in half, or the necklace, so that you have a little bit of space there too, because as the wire curves around the beads, it needs to be a little bit longer. Then we're going to add another crimp bead, same size. And I do like the bottles that the crimp beads come in. It makes it so easy to keep things tidy. String on the crimp bead. And then I take the clasp apart to attach. Just, it's easier than trying to have the whole thing connected. String through, then back through your crimp bead. And again, you're going to have that crossover, but it becomes easier as you notice it and then take whatever you're crimping to and use that to twist the wire so that it will be parallel on the inside. The two wires are parallel. Then get that loop about the same size as the other one. And you want to leave a little bit of space because we're going to put a crimp cover there as well. Again, taking the pliers. Make sure that's parallel. We're going to oval it. Then we're going to bean shape it. We're going to turn it 90 degrees. And we're going to crimp this down. And again, This works with the number of the crimp bead or the crimp tube and the wire, because we've designed it to make sure everything goes together well. Mm. That's why you don't need to put extra smashing on it. And again, just snip it. And then pull these back a little bit so we can put our crimp cover. Over that, just the same as we did the other one. Just pop that in there. Mighty crimp plier. And you don't want to catch that, the wire in the closure. You want to just keep kind of turning it and moving it so that you can get that to just clamp down. And you want that seam to be as closed without being smashed, which takes a little bit of practice, but then you're good. So now we have our finished piece that's professionally crimped, has the crimp cover over the crimp bead, and has the proper amount of cush from those bead bumpers, mm-hmm. so that you can do something like this, and it's still got a little bit of give. So that gives it a really, really nice, it's using wire and getting the feel of textile.
Wyatt, great job. I mean, you make it look so easy. So, Wyatt, the other pieces that you have in front of us, do you mind explaining that to us and see what's what that's all about?
Yeah, that's a design that I created many years ago, and we call it the Watusi stringing style. Another basic stringing technique, utilizing three strands of wire instead of just one.
Okay.
What we did earlier was a single strand. Now this is using two strands. There's two strands going through the center, and then a third strand that sort of watusis around those beads.
So if somebody really wants to see this technique done, do you have this up on your website?
We do. They can go to the Beadalon website, and it's in the gallery. And you can find all of the instructions on it. There's also a YouTube video on the Beadalon YouTube channel.
Nice, nice. I'd like to take this opportunity, Wyatt, to say thank you so much for helping our customers learn about bead stringing and basic jewelry making. So
it was my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Thanks. I know people are really going to enjoy this segment. Again, I'm Nick Regine, the Professor of Crystal, answering all your crystal application questions. We look forward to bringing you new episodes featuring fun, creative, and easy ways to use Swarovski elements. Remember to visit our website at www.createyourstyle.com, and please share your designs on our Facebook fan page and follow us on Pinterest. We also welcome your postings, comments, and questions.